Today's lesson is Lesson 5, God's Way in the Sanctuary. So let's begin with a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your blessings of this day. Please give us more wisdom and knowledge and understanding on your sanctuary. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. Many years after the death of Abel, God's followers were living in Egypt. They had become slaves to the Egyptians and were forced to work very hard and were often beaten by their slave masters. They had forgotten most of what God had taught them about his way of salvation. They were very sad and discouraged and needed help. God felt sorry for them and sent Moses to lead them out of Egypt and back to the country God had given to them years before. But before God could lead them all the way into the promised land, he had to teach them again about his way of salvation. Out in the desert wilderness, he gave them an illustration of his way that they could see and understand. God said, "And let them make me a sanctuary that I may dwell among them." Exodus 25:8. Through the services of the sanctuary, God would teach his people how to be saved from sin. The Bible says, "Thy way, O God, is in the sanctuary," and that's found in Psalm 77:13. This sanctuary was made to show the people of earth what the sanctuary in heaven was like and how God works through the sanctuary services to save his people from sin. The sanctuary on earth was made in such a way that it could be taken apart and moved whenever the people moved to a new place. It was set up right in the center of their camp so that everyone could find it easily. It was a simple building with two rooms, which were separated by a curtain or veil. Surrounding it was a large outer court with a curtain fence around it. There were only a few pieces of furniture in each section of the sanctuary, but these were very important. Each one represented a part of God's way of salvation. There were two pieces of furniture in the outer court. One was the altar of sacrifice or burnt offering. It was a brass altar on which the animal offerings were burnt. The other was a large brass basin which was filled with water. In the first room of the building, which was called the Holy Place, there were three pieces of furniture. On the north side was a low table on which 12 fresh loaves of bread were placed every Sabbath. On the south side was a large lampstand with 7 branches. Each branch had a lamp, and these lamps were kept burning day and night. Straight ahead, in front of the veil separating the two rooms, was a smaller altar called the Altar of Incense. It had a small fire burning on it, which only God himself had started, and which was never allowed to go out. Inside the veil was the second room, called the Most Holy Place. It was smaller than the first room and held only one piece of furniture. But this was the most sacred of all. It was like a box with a golden angel standing on each end of it. The lid of the box was called the mercy seat, and from here a bright light shone over the curtain. I have to stop for a second so you can see it clearly. This light shone that God was present there right in the midst of the whole camp of Israel. At night, the people could see the glow of that light, and they knew God was watching over them. It also contained two flat stones called the tables of stone upon which God wrote the Ten Commandments with his own finger. This is why it was so sacred. God chose Aaron, the brother of Moses, to be the high priest in the sanctuary. He wore very special garments to show that he represented Jesus, our high priest in heaven. The sons of Aaron and later his grandsons were also priests. They also wore simple white garments when they ministered in the sanctuary. They were like ministers or pastors in the church today. Their work was to help the people to follow God's way of salvation. So, this sanctuary that you see behind me is a copy of what is in heaven, God's way in the sanctuary. Let us have prayer. Father, thank you for giving us more information on your sanctuary and your way of salvation. In Jesus' name, amen. See you next time.
Brothers and sisters, this is Pastor Josh here, and I want to tell you guys about an incredible offer that I have. And it's right here. It's a book called The Sanctuary Simplified. And now we're offering this book absolutely free. No cost to you. You don't even have to pay postage. All you have to do is contact me by email, or you can contact me by regular USPS mail, slow mail. And all you gotta do is write to me and let me know that you're interested in a book and leave me your address, and I'll send this book absolutely free to you. And it's amazing. It talks about the heavenly sanctuary and tells you everything you need to know about it. If you don't know already, the sanctuary is the pathway to salvation. It's the blueprint of salvation. It's the image of the cross. It's extremely important if you are a Christian to understand what the sanctuary message is. Because if you don't, you will not be able to interpret prophecy properly. Okay? So this book, it breaks things down in a very simple format, and it's absolutely crucial that you understand this. So I beg of you guys, please write me, and I will send this book absolutely free, no cost to you, not asking for anything of you. It's just important that you get this material. And this company that makes this book, they actually make lots of great books, and it's all concerning the sanctuary and concerning the fit man, okay, who drags the scapegoat out into the wilderness. Now, if you'd like to get in touch with them, you can as well. They have an email address. It's fitman.publications@gmail.com. Or if you want to get a hold of me personally, you can do that. If you want to get this free offer, write me, Pastor Josh. The email address is pastorjosh2011@gmail.com. And the physical address is P.O. Box 413, Volcano, Hawaii, 96785, United States of America. Hope to hear from you soon, guys. And remember, we are actually studying this exact book in our Sanctuary Simplified series. So make sure you tune into that and write us. Let us know what's happening. Send in your prayer requests. Remember, this is absolutely free. It costs nothing to you. All right. Hope to hear from you guys. God bless you.